Hey Cloud Gurus, ready to test your new AWS skills and take a certification exam? Great, let me show you how to book an exam and how to know if you've passed and check your score. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to book an AWS certification. We're gonna head to aws.amazon.com/certifications and we're gonna hit schedule an exam. Keep in mind that in order to schedule an exam, you actually need to sign in with an Amazon account and not an AWS account, right? So we're gonna hit sign in and we're gonna select Amazon and we're gonna hit sign in here. Gonna hit sign in there. Fantastic. Now this should take us to our AWS certification account and I'm gonna click on go to your account. Let's hit on schedule new exam. Let's find the exam that we're looking for and I'm going to select the AWS Certified Developer Associate and I'm going to select Schedule with Pearson View. First off, it's going to ask us, how do you want to take your exam? I'm going to select online from my home or office. We also have the option to take the exam at a local test center or use a private access code. This is typically provided to you by an exam sponsor, and this is sometimes needed to schedule an exam, but this isn't the case here, so we're just going to select online from my home or office. Now, you do see here sort of a note, which tells us that your machine needs to meet minimum requirements, so I would highly suggest clicking on that link, because it's going to take you to a testing program that's going to make sure that your machine is going to work to take this exam. Alrighty. So now I'm gonna hit next. Alrighty, so we have now the online exam policies that we have to agree to by checking each one of these boxes. Now, for the purpose of this video, to keep it brief, I'm not gonna review everything, but please make sure to take the time to actually do that. Now we're going to select our preferred language for the exam. I'm gonna select English. Fantastic, now we have the exam details. We're gonna make sure this is the correct exam that we want to take. Looks like the price is 150 USD. The language we selected is English, right? And we see we have a notice here that says, if you are taking an online proctored exam in an available country, we strongly recommend using a personal computer and a wired Ethernet connection. Now, take some time to read this over. Alrighty, and now we're gonna hit next. Now, what is the language you prefer the proctor to speak? English is my option. I'm gonna hit next. Now we're gonna actually select a day to take this exam. I'm gonna select in March. I wanna take it on Monday the 15th. I'm gonna select the 12-hour format so it can show me which times are available. 1 p.m. is perfect. Just verify that the description of the exam, the language, and the details are correct for you. And now we can go ahead and proceed to checkout. You will now be presented with AWS policies that go over the system requirements, admission policy, reschedule policy, and cancellation policy. So just make sure to take a look at that before you hit accept. Now we can fill in our billing information. Alrighty, once you're ready, hit next. And this is one final time to check in all the details, your description, your details, the price, the exams for your name, make sure your AWS ID is correct, the order total, and then you're gonna see subtotal, tax, total due, and just the last four of the card that you're using to pay for this. And then you can hit submit order and you're done. One last thing I do wanna show you is back in the AWS certification dashboard, which would be your AWS certification account. This is where we initially scheduled our exam, but we also have options to view our previous exams, upcoming exams, achieved certifications. If you've taken any AWS certifications, and here you'll see them listed, started, active, last day to recertify, and then you can download your certificate in here. And then you have digital badges and access to anything AWS certification related from this portal.
Great. We've booked an exam and we know we have the option to book an online exam or an in-person exam. We took a few minutes to go over the prerequisites your machine must meet. We also know we can expect a pass or fail result within a few minutes of finishing our exam, and a more detailed report in our AWS certification dashboard. Are you taking an AWS certification soon? Let us know in the comments and make sure to subscribe for more awesome cloud content. That's it for this episode of ACG Fundamentals. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. I'll see you in the next one.